Good morning. I'm Dan Perrine, and this is my dog, Carmel. She's actually named Carmel Latte because she looks like a favorite drink of ours, Carmel Latte. Okay, you ready to read, Carmel? Okay. We're going to read a book today called Winnie the Pooh, Eeyore, Be Happy. Sometimes we're not very happy, but this is going to show us how we can be happy all the time. If Pooh had felt any happier, his stuffing would have popped. That's the sort of day it was in the 100-acre wood. Fluffy white clouds were keeping the sun company. Chirping birds were keeping the trees company. And Piglet was keeping Pooh company on the path to Pooh Sticks Bridge. A fine day for playing pool sticks, Pooh said, bending over to pick up a small branch. A perfect day, said Piglet, agreed, finding a stick for himself. Holding their poo sticks, the two friends hurried onto Poo Stick Bridge. If you've never been to 100 Acre Wood and played poo sticks, you probably don't know how to play the game. Poo sticks is easy. It was invented by Pooh, who isn't a very complicated bear. When they played, Pooh and Piglet each dropped their sticks into the river. Then they ran over the other side of the bridge. If Pooh's stick floated out first, then Pooh won. As they leaned over the side, the two friends saw a familiar orange and black striped tail sticking out from under the bridge. That's Tinker's tail, declared Pooh. Do you think he lost it? Piglet said in his worried voice. No, said the tail. The rest of me is here, too. Pooh and Piglet leaned over it a bit more, careful not to fall into the river. There was Tigger, sitting on the riverbank below. Whatever are you doing there, Pooh said. Why aren't you having fun bouncing? Bouncing was what Tigger liked to do the best. Eeyore spoiled everything, Tigger answered. He said that nice weather like this is earthquake weather. He said the 100-acre wood would probably have an earthquake today. I'm staying on the bridge until it's over, and you'd better too. You know what an earthquake is? I don't think we have very many earthquakes in Reading, but they shake the earth really bad. Meanwhile, Christopher Robin was in the 100-acre wood, growing worried. He hadn't seen Pooh or Piglet all day, so he decided to start looking for them. First, he looked in Pooh's elf-a-lump trap. Sometimes Pooh and Piglet fell in the trap. They weren't there. Then Christopher Robin went to Rabbit's house. Pooh and Piglet often went there for lunch, whether Rabbit invited them or not. But Rabbit said he hadn't seen them all day. Finally, Christopher Robin found them sitting under the Pooh Sticks Bridge. They had been sitting there a long time. When Pooh told him what Eeyore had said about earthquake weather, Christopher laughed. Silly bear, he said. There's no such thing as earthquake weather. Eeyore was just being gloomy again. I could have been bouncing all day, Tigger said grumpily. And Pooh and I could have played Pooh Sticks all day, Piglet said. Bother, said Pooh, who had missed his lunch because of Eeyore. Pooh led the way to a gloomy place where Eeyore lived. They found the little donkey nibbling at a patch of thistles near the gloomy little house. You said there was going to be an earthquake, Eeyore, Tigger said, and you spoiled our whole day. Eeyore could tell by the tone of his friend's voice that he was annoyed. Why do you always have to be so gloomy about everything? Asked Piglet. It's nicer to be happy than gloomy, said Pooh. Perhaps it is, Eeyore agreed, but I don't know how to be happy. Nobody ever showed me. It's easy to be happy, Tigger cried. Just follow me. Tigger started bouncing off across Eeyore's gloomy place. Eeyore took a few practice bounces, then bounced off behind Tigger. Feeling very happy, Tigger bounced higher and higher. Look out, Christopher shouted, but it was too late. Tigger and Eeyore bounced right into a big, swampy mud puddle. Do you like to play in mud puddles? I remember when I was a boy, I liked to play in mud puddles. I don't think bouncing makes me happy, said Eeyore, as everyone helped pull the bouncers from the puddle. Then come with me, said Pooh. I'll show you what makes me happy. We know what makes you happy, don't we? Playing ball, yeah. Pooh took Eeyore and the others to his house. Being happy means having a cupboard full of pots of honey from the honey tree, Pooh says as he opened the cupboard. Christopher looked in one pot. This pot's empty, he said. Tigger looked at another. So is this one. Oh, bother, said Pooh. I forgot. My honey pots are all empty. I shall have to get some more. Pooh's friends went with him to the honey tree. Pooh explained how to get honey from the honey tree. It's simply a matter of climbing up and taking the honey from the bees, he told Eeyore. Try it. He boosted Eeyore up the first branch. Now just keep climbing until you see the place where the bees keep the honey, Pooh said. Eeyore looked scared. Christopher said to him, don't worry, if you'll slip, we'll catch you. Eeyore kept climbing until he came to a hollowed out place in the tree trunk. He reached inside and felt around for the honey. In a second, he was surrounded by angry bees. Eeyore threw himself back and came tumbling out of the tree right on top of Pooh. They all picked themselves up and ran as fast as they could to Piglet's house. The bees swarmed after them, buzzing angrily. As he ran, Eeyore cried, I don't think taking honey from the honey tree makes me happy. But then it was Piglet's turn to show Eeyore how to be happy. Luckily, the bees didn't follow them all the way to Piglet's house. Once they were there, Piglet said, I feel happy when I'm painting my house. Eeyore, why don't you try it? He went to the garage to get some paint. Eeyore had never climbed a ladder before. Piglet tried to hold the ladder to keep it from shaking, but Piglet was small, and the ladder was big, and Eeyore was shaky. Halfway up the ladder, Eeyore tripped on his own tail. Christopher and Tigger saw the ladder sway and tried to grab it, but Eeyore toppled over right on top of the spilled paint. I don't think house painting makes me happy, Eeyore said, dripping with paint. His friends helped him to his feet and tried to wipe him off. Thank you anyway, said Eeyore. Thank you all for trying to show me how to be happy. He slowly headed off toward the gloomy home, a gloomy place. That evening, after a good bath, Eeyore sat in front of his little house. He looked up at the star-sprinkled sky. He looked at the big round moon. Hurricane weather, he said to himself gloomily. One day of happiness was enough. It was good to be gloomy again. The end.